Gandhi leaves behind to us, the ability to take ethical positions, declared ethical positions, and act on that declared position. For him, it was fearlessness, abhay, it was ahimsa, non-violence. He believed in this, he believed in Hindu-Muslim unity, he stood for that and acted on that. And these are not just actions in my public sphere of activity, but this is also how I lead my private personal life. Too many times in leaders, we see this divergence between the public persona and the private persona. Gandhi didn't have that division at all. He didn't believe in it. He believed, as he once said, my life is my message. So what he believed in, he stood for that in every single sphere of his life. And I think that's the most important message that Gandhi leaves behind to us. Immediately after the violence in Chauri Chaura in 1922, February 1922, at quite the height of the non-cooperation movement, when he withdrew the movement by saying, one of the fundamental principles of my life has been violated by this violence and I can no longer be associated with this movement. In Ahmedabad in 1923, he tells the court, non-violence is the first article of my faith, it is also the last article of my creed. One of the first things that he did was to completely identify himself with the commonest people of India. He did it first by refashioning his image. So he never wore, after 1915, he never wore any urban clothing. He dressed himself and made his appearance into that of the commonest Indian peasant. When we think of Gandhi, we think of him bare-bodied, loincloth, shaft in hand. That's also the image of the common peasant of India. In the court, when he is asked, he's at the dock, of course, in the dock, and the judge asks him, your name, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, your occupation, farmer and weaver. He doesn't say he's a barrister at law, he doesn't say he's the leader of the Congress, X, Y, Z, he could have said. He never spoke down to his audience. He spoke as if he was in conversation with them, you know. He was willing to believe that he had something to learn from the people as well. There is more to take from them in terms of ideas, in terms of ways of living, in terms of modes of tolerance and coexistence that they practice without even thinking. Most of the time in the social sector, we go there because we think we have something to give. Either it's education or it's money or training or something like that. Of course, these are things to be imparted, but there are also things to be learned. And Gandhi had that attitude. I have to learn from these people. Once he moved around the people of India, he also got to know that his beliefs were not just abstract, his beliefs were livable. Gandhi is a living presence in India. As long as we have poverty in this country, we cannot turn our back to Gandhi.